Welcome back and hello. This is Stephen K. De Silva, and I'm doing a live Facebook presentation from Prosperous Soul Headquarters. I haven't been live for a while, so I thought I would jump on. I've been posting videos and working hard on some new products, but we'll talk about that another day. What I wanted to do today was just kind of welcome everybody back to a live chat and talk about something. My wife and I were out walking this past weekend, and you know, when we go for these walks, we do a lot of prayer and we do a lot of conversation. It's funny, we can sit in the house on the couch or in the kitchen, we'll be doing our routine, but we talk. But when we take our walks, we really talk. And so what happened this weekend is it was a Saturday, and it's a little smoky in Redding. We're here in California, and for some reason, the smoke was really socked into our area, and it was terrible. But we were out trying to find some time, and we got to talking about some of the drama that we're hearing and learning from our friends and from people around. Hey, Megan, it's great to have you, girl. Thanks for watching. But we were realizing that Donna and I, we kind of live in a bubble. You know, we have some isolation or some insulation from some of the drama that is really playing out in some homes, and we need to pray for that. We need to pray for our brothers and sisters, our friends, people we don't even know that are really struggling through this COVID season. And we were just talking about that. In fact, we were saying, man, I wish I had the power of God in my, you know, in my spiritual doctrine gun or something. I could go shoot some of these problems down. I was thinking, I would love to be able to just extend my hand like Moses on the river and say, you know, debt go in Jesus' name, and just have debt evaporate from people's lives. I would love to be able to see income. Just, God, would you provide for this family or that friend? And just see, you know, the power out of the sky, or however that happens, I don't know. But this is what I wish is that I had that kind of anointing. Probably because I'm influenced by Hollywood and the superpowers and you know, Thor with his hammer or whatever's going on. I just wish I had that. And Donna and I were talking about, man, I remember when revival was new, how things were, you know, anointed. It felt like we were just in a great season during those times of power displays. We were seeing healings and prophecies and all these things. And Donna and I honestly were like, man, I wish I still had that. I wish I had that power of God. And yeah, well, let me tell you what happened this morning. I was reading through my Bible. And I'm in Galatians chapter 6 today. And the Lord, the Holy Spirit, hits me right between the eyes and says, here it is. You know, this is a, just before I go on, I have to say, read your Bible brand new. It's like a living document. We know that, but it is alive today. It's like the body of Christ is re-entering biblical times with our needs and turmoils and dramas and exterior pressures. With shut-ins and you know, shelter in and COVID and disease and all this stuff, economics and all these things. It's like the Bible is fresh and new and alive. And I'm reading my way through I'm in the New Testament. I started originally around Easter, and I started with the Easter story in the book of Luke. Well, I started at the beginning of Luke, but I was just reading through. Well, now I've made it to Galatians chapter 6, and I'm reading it in four different translations, just trying to really see what's going on. It's so alive. I highly recommend it. Read your Bible and listen for the Holy Spirit information that's flowing. Anyway, I did that, and I found it today, and I want to share with you the secret that there is a way I can show you where to find the power of God and how to release it. And so that's today's subject. Well, here's the spoiler alert. It's right here. It's in your hand. And It's whatever you have to give. I'll explain it in Paul's words in just a moment. So you don't have to take it from me, but it's literally right here. And when Donna and I were walking around the block and talking about needs and burdens, that struggles that people are facing, I got to thinking, man, I wish I had this superpower lightning bolt out of my hand, but here it is, and I'll give you this address. I'm reading from 2,000 years ago, give or take, Paul the Apostle, and he's telling this church, the Galatian church, and it's in chapter 6, and I'm just going to hit one verse. Verse 2, chapter 6, verse 2. Bear one another's burdens. Bear one another's burdens, and thereby fulfill the law of Christ. Oh my gosh. I'm like, Paul, you're killing me. That's amazing. That was the New American Standard. Let me read it to you in the Message. It says, this is Galatians 6, verse 2 in the Message translation. Stoop down and reach out to those who are oppressed. Share their burdens and so complete the Christ's law. If you think you are too good for that, you are badly deceived. That's verse 3. But I just thought, oh, Lord. You know, because I realize that everyone has a hand or two that they can share with other people's burdens, whether it's the neighbor or your friend or your family member. We need to be actively bearing one another's burdens. You know, I know this. I know it because I've read the Bible numerous times, especially the New Testament. I've read it. I've heard it taught to me. I've taught it myself. But here I am reading the word and hearing it again. Oh my gosh, it's got to get back in here. And I've got to get to work, which I do, but it's like a fresh wake-up call. It's like, oh my goodness, I am a superhero. And these are times when the world is desperate. And if ever there's a time for the body of Christ to be faithfully executing the law of Christ, that law that is written on our hearts, that we would love the Lord our God with all our heart and mind, and our neighbor as ourselves, it's so simple, and everyone can do it. No one has an excuse. None of us can say, well, I'm out of work right now. I can't really help. Or I'm under such great burden, I can't do this right now. I need someone to do it for me. No, so get out there and put some seed in the ground. Use your hands and work with the burdens of your neighbors. Listen to this. Galatians 6. I'm going to jump down to verse 7, 8, 9, 10. I'll just read 7. Verse 7. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, what he's working with his hands, this he will also reap. Wow. You want to reap the law of Christ in your life? Then you want to sow the law of Christ. You want to bear one another's burdens. If you think you're too busy or too high or unable, you're deceived. You can do it. So be encouraged. Whatever it is, I don't care if it's the tiniest thing, give it. If it's a word of encouragement, if it's a kindness, give it. Do this. I have to read this, verse 9. Let us not lose heart in doing good. For in due time, we will reap if we do not grow weary. Wow. Paul, in the book of Galatians, chapter 6. Go read it yourself in your favorite translation. But if you're weary of doing well, if you feel like COVID is too heavy, or you know the time length is too long, if you're short on income, if you don't have a job, hey man, I get that. I get that. If you don't have some things, ask of God for a harvest. But don't forget to keep sowing. Be faithful in the law of Christ. You want to see the power of God in your life? I know I do. Well, then let's get to work with our hands and bear one another's burdens. Let's do what Jesus did. Well, hey, that's all I have to do today. I appreciate you guys for jumping on. And if you can, share the video. Shoot it around with some friends. Let's see if we can tell some other people. It might encourage them. Eh, I hope so. And more importantly, release the power of God in their life today like it is in ours. I bless you in Jesus' name. And if you're a person who is in need, I just want you to put your hand on your heart right now, and I'm going to pray, and all of everyone else, pray with us for the ones in need. Father God, the one we believe created us and the world, who sent his Son for us, I ask now in Jesus' name for the power of the gospel to be released in our homes against the foes of debt, against COVID and the disease and the struggle that's going on, against isolation and sheltering in, and the need for that, against struggles with income. Father, if we need jobs, I ask you to open them. I have a special friend who needs a home. I'm asking for homes across the needs of our people. We ask this in Jesus' name with faith, not with weary fear, but with hope and faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you guys, and thanks so much for watching, and God bless your prosperous soul. Bye-bye. Hey, thanks for watching. I'm Stephen K. DeSilva, and you're probably wondering, why have I never heard this information before? Well, now you can by going up into this corner and subscribing to this channel. Or you can go to this corner and watch the next video. There is tons of information I'm giving you. Go check it out and go deeper. Or better yet, go to the link below and go check out my website. I've got some free stuff on there. Go get that and go see lots of resources so you can finally master your money. Hey, I gotta go record another video. I'll see you soon. Bye.